Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 3rd of June. Exit polls project PM Modi's alliance to win big in India election. Heat wave scorches parts of Pakistan and India. And Maldives bans Israeli passport holders over war on Gaza. And now for all the details. India this past weekend concluded voting in the gigantic seven-phased elections, which began on April 19, saw 642 million of the 968 million registered voters exercise their right to franchise. In the first comments following the conclusion of vote, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi exuded confidence and said people have voted in record numbers to re-elect his BJP-led NDA government. The opportunist India Alliance failed to strike a chord with voters, he said in a post on X. While the pre-election surveys have said BJP would easily keep its majority, the exit polls or post-election surveys have predicted the ruling NDA could win a two-third majority in the 543-member lower house of parliament. It is being predicted PM Modi's BJP might secure more than 303 seats it won in 2019. However, the opposition have dismissed the predictions and has called them prefixed in favour of government. Opposition India bloc leaders are confident they will secure more than 295 seats in Lok Sabha, where 272 seats are needed for a simple majority. The Election Commission will count votes on 4th of June.
इसका नाम एग्जिट पोल नहीं है, इसका नाम मोदी मीडिया पोल है. ये मोदी जी का पोल है, फैंटेसी पोल है उनका. थैंक यू.
कितनी सीटें आ रही हैं आपके हिसाब से?
सिद्धू मूसेवाला का सॉन्ग सुना आपने? 295.
केरला में जो है वो आप कुश्ती कर रहे थे और दिल्ली में दोस्ती दिखा रहे थे. पंजाब में जो है वो आप झगड़ा कर रहे थे, दिल्ली में झप्पी कर रहे थे. बंगाल में आप जो है वो कुश्ती कर रहे थे और दिल्ली में आप दोस्ती दिखा रहे थे. ये इस तरह के गठबंधन और इस तरह के विकल्प के आधार पर जो है वो आप कहते हैं कि जी हम जो है वो क्या है 290 पार करेंगे, 300 पार करेंगे. मुझे लगता है कि आज इसके अलावा एक इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज है कि जो इनके साथ लोग हैं भी वो भी इस बात को जानते हैं कि कांग्रेस पार्टी की जमीन तो बंजर है लेकिन उसके हाथ में आज भी बेवफाई का खंजर है. और इनको लगता है कि अगर बिना जमीन के जमींदारी और बिना जनाधार के जागीरदारी की जो जंग इनकी चल रही है, जुआड़ी जंग, उसमें कोई बहुत कामयाबी हासिल कर लेंगे, तो ये उनकी गलतफहमी भी है और सपने भी
है. इन अ रिकॉर्ड हाई, इंडियाज डिजिटल पेमेंट इंटरफेस दिस पास्ट मंथ clocked a new high value as it processed 14.4 billion transactions worth almost 20 trillion rupees. In a post on X, the National Payment Corporation of India said the UPI transactions in May saw an increase of 6% compared to 13.30 billion transactions in April and 4% in value terms against 19.64 trillion rupees last month. This comes after a minor dip was witnessed in April as per NPCI data. Reports suggest the data for May is also highest in terms and volume since UPI operations began in the country. Unified Payment Interface, more commonly known by acronym UPI, is an indigenous real-time payment system developed by NPCI which facilitates interbank transactions. The payment system is also operational outside other countries like Singapore, UAE and Nepal, with the latest in the list being France and Sri Lanka. India and Pakistan are continuing to swelter through heat wave conditions, with residents struggling to cope up. Scientists have blamed climate change for the unusual summer temperatures. Take a look.
Residents in Pakistan's port city of Karachi made their way to the beach this past weekend to cool down during a persistent heat wave that has plagued the country. Weather officials said temperatures were around 38 to 40 degrees Celsius on Sunday, but were amplified due to humid conditions. Extreme temperatures throughout Asia over the past month were made worse, most likely as a result of human-driven climate change, a team of international scientists have said.
Karachi mein bardasht se bahar garmi hai, to garmi ki shiddat ko kam karne ke liye hum log ne samandar ka rukh kiya hai, jo ke family ke saath aaye the, thoda enjoy ho jata hai. Baaki jagah Karachi mein to hai nahi ghumne ki, samandar pe hi aa sakte hain, to samandar pe aaye the family ko leke. वीकेंड आया थे, एंजॉय कर लिए थे।
कराची में जिस तरह अभी मौजूदा गर्मी की लहर चल रही है और जिस तरह का हीट वेव है, इसमें घर में काम करना बहुत मुश्किल हो गया है। इसी वजह से हम थोड़ा सा सी साइड आ जाते हैं, थोड़ा रिलीफ के लिए बच्चों को ले आते हैं, तो ये एक हमारे लिए सस्ती पिकनिक भी है और जो है ना थोड़ा गर्मी दूर भगाने का एक तरीका भी है।
Meanwhile, people in parts of northern India have also been experiencing a blisteringly hot summer, which is also affecting animals and birds, with temperatures touching 50 degrees Celsius in several areas. A senior doctor at the Charity Birds Hospital in New Delhi said, while humans have been facing the heat, he has seen cases of heat stroke and mortality rates increase for birds due to extreme temperatures. He urged residents to protect their feathered friends by leaving out bowls of water for thirsty birds.
और बढ़ती गर्मी में जितने भी पंछी हैं, जिसमें कि सबसे ज़्यादा हमारे पास कबूतर हैं, वो आ रहे हैं। इसको हम हीट स्ट्रोक में कंसीडर करते हैं कि इसको हीट स्ट्रोक का केस है ये, तो उसकी वजह से मोर्टैलिटी भी काफ़ी हो रही है इनमें। तो यही है कि बढ़ते हुए टेम्परेचर को देखते हुए हमें ये देखना चाहिए कि जगह जगह पानी के बाउल्स वगैरह रखें, जिससे कि बर्ड्स को आसानी से पानी मिले और उनको हीट स्ट्रोक से बचाया जा सके।
Moving on, a massive protest was held by traders in POJK recently to demand implementation of subsidies, release of their arrested leaders and criminal case against the Prime Minister over deaths of protesters in violence in May.
Scores of traders in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir recently held a protest to demand release of their arrested leaders and filing of case against POJK Prime Minister Chaudhry Anwarul Haq over the deaths of four people during protests against inflation in May. They also demanded the government to give compensation to the families of the three protesters and a police official who were killed in the violence. They lamented there has been no implementation of subsidies on flour and electricity prices as assured by Pakistan government, over which they had called off their protests.
पहला मुतालबा हमारे भाइयों हमारे बहनों को रिहा किया जाए, दूसरा मुतालबा हमारे जो भाई शहीद हुए हैं उसके जुर्म में वजीर आजम चीफ सेक्रेटरी आईजी को मुजरिम बनाकर उनके खिलाफ पर्चा दर्ज किया जाए और उन्हें गिरफ्तार किया जाए। कह रहे हैं आप मुझे बताएं हमारा आटा सस्ता हुआ, हमारी बिजली सस्ती हुई, इसमें इन्होंने नई नई लिस्ट जारी करके ताकि आवाम और ताजियों को आपस में घपला हो, ये आपस में लड़ाई करे और हम एशिया में बैठ के फिर इनके फोकस।
लोकल से इट इज आयरोनिक that the region fulfills Pakistan's electricity needs, but instead they have to suffer.
हम ये कहते हैं अपना हक मांगते हैं 350 मेगावाट, जब तुम 50 मेगावाट बिजली पैदा होती है 350 साल में तुम्हें तो क्या तकलीफ होती है।
Locals in POJK say they are being forced to bear the brunt of Pakistan's economic crisis in the form of hike in taxes and soaring inflation, and they see no relief in near future.
Meanwhile, the Taliban have dismissed the findings of a Pakistani probe that attributed a suicide bombing that killed 5 Chinese engineers in northwest Pakistan to militants operating from Afghanistan. The victims were working on a China-funded hydropower project. Taliban spokesperson Zabihullah Mujahid told an Afghan television station that Afghans had nothing to do with the March 26 attack, insisting it was an internal issue for the neighboring country to address. The report published by Pakistan is an attempt to damage the trust between Afghanistan and China. We have repeatedly denied this report as illogical, Mujahid said. Pakistani government and military officials maintain that Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan or TTP orchestrated the attack. While the Taliban's regime has not been formally recognized by any country so far, China has steadily improved ties with Afghanistan. Beijing was the first to appoint a new ambassador to Kabul and the first to officially accept a Taliban ambassador. In a mark of protest, Maldives this past weekend imposed a ban on Israelis barring the entry of the Israel passport holders in the island nation. In a statement, Maldives President's office said President Mohamed Muizu has imposed the restriction following cabinet recommendation and added that the decision includes amending necessary laws to prevent Israeli passport holders from entering Maldives and establishing a cabinet subcommittee to oversee these efforts. Following the move, Israel's foreign ministry has recommended Israeli nationals, including those holding dual citizenship, to leave the island nation immediately. The ministry said it is recommended to consider leaving because if they find themselves in distress for any reason, it will be difficult for it to assist. The archipelago nation doesn't have diplomatic ties with Tel Aviv, but it allowed tourists from Israel after removal of a similar restriction in early 1990s. However, following the continued offensive action by Israel in Hamas-controlled Gaza Strip, Mali decided to reimpose the ban, enactment of which is still unknown. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.